Hello, have yourself a seat, sit down, get comfortable. Yeah, if you're gonna get a tattoo from me, that means that you instantly become part of the family. So, did you already speak to Jalissa at the front? Okay, so you signed the consent form. Excellent. So, I still have to ask you a few questions. It will be quick, though, I promise you that. So, your first and last name. And your date of birth. So, is this your first tattoo? Have you consumed any alcohol in the last 12 hours? And any painkillers? The reason why I ask that is because, well, we are using a needle after all, and alcohol is a blood thinner, and certain painkillers are also blood thinners as well. So I just like to be So, do you know exactly where you want your tattoo placed? Okay, awesome. So, your right arm around this area. Okay, this area right here. We can definitely do that for you. Is it going to be a large piece, small piece? Okay, so you're not quite sure what you want exactly. Oh, okay, so this is going to be your first piece to start your sleeve. How exciting! Okay, so, are you looking for something traditional, modern? Do you want a colored piece, a black piece, portrait? Yes, there's even white tattoos as well. But they can be a little, a little more troublesome than your standard black tattoo or just your color tattoo. So, let's see. I have this book here. Maybe this will give you some inspiration. And of course, we have many books here at our shop. So, you can feel free to browse around. But you said you want something, a little mystical. So, how about fairies? I feel like fairies are always a win. These are very colorful fairies. Yeah, they're definitely no Tinkerbell. And these are some just black tattoos. Those are really pretty. I quite like those. Of course, you can go with a floral design. These are some flowers with some like tribal designs as well. Those are quite nice. These are really pretty as well. Nice pop of color. This one is really pretty. This butterfly right here. Oh, you like the blue roses? Yeah, that is stunning. I love that. Now, of course, we can make a custom piece. I'm just showing you these for just pure inspiration. Some more butterflies. Oh, this is very Beauty and the Beast. He loves Beauty and the Beast. Yeah, it just reminds me of Beauty and the Beast because of all the colors. The yellows, the reds, the blues. And of course we have the black tattoos as well. Okay, so you know for sure you want a color tattoo. Okay. We're getting somewhere. Yes, I definitely will be able to get your tattoo done today. I have extra time in my schedule. Yeah, today is my day for just pure walk-ins. Let's see. Yeah, these are some traditional pieces. You know, your snakes and flowers. The anchors. Okay. So we have some moons here, and these are really, really cute. So, there we have some moons. I feel like they're very, kawaii. Especially this one right here. This crescent moon. You really love these. Let's see if there's any other moons. Look at this mood. This mood is not happy at all. I love it. These are just some like smaller moon and sun designs. Okay, so you really like these two here. Okay, well, I can definitely do a mixture of the two. Are you still in love with the colors? Okay. Yeah, we can definitely do that. So, what I'm going to do is I'm going to sketch out a little design for you. I'll sketch out a couple, actually. And you can tell me which one you prefer, and we will go on from there. Is there anything else that you want to add to the mood, like a saying? Okay. Excellent. So I think we have it. I think that you are absolutely going to love your tattoo. I'm so glad that we figured out what exactly you're looking for. So I am going to go ahead and draw out two different designs for you. I have my transfer stencil sheets here. So you can just sit down right over there, or across the street. There's actually a really amazing coffee shop. They make the best coffee and they have the best bagels. Highly recommend. This is only going to take about 15 minutes, maybe even less. Yeah, super quick. Okay. Yeah, I've been doing this for years. So, yeah, just relax. Yeah, they also have free Wi-Fi over there. Okay. Thank you. So I see you went over to the coffee shop. Did you enjoy it? Yeah, I told you. Really good. Okay, yeah, I just finished up. So, here we have option number one. I completely agree. This is option number two and number two. So here we have option number two. Yeah, this one is slightly larger than the first one. Okay, yeah, that's fine. So, yeah, we can totally do that. So, you like the second option, but you just want, the eyes from the first one. We can totally do that. I actually can just fix that really quickly. Yeah. So, like that. Okay. Yeah, quick fix. We didn't have to, yeah, go ahead and draw another. Okay, so before we even put on our stencil, we do need to prep your arm. So I'm going to have to ask for your arm. Okay, so we're just gonna place it right here. Okay, and we are going to be shaving off some of that arm hair. You don't have a lot. I'm gonna put some gloves. We are going to take some shaving gel. And shave some of the hair. So, are you comfortable? Okay. So, this is super simple. Right on the area. I'm also going to be taking some water. And just wetting the area. Not too much. And just going to shave this. Yes, we do this, of course, just so you have a clean canvas. what'd you say? You have the look of the Irish. Normally, you don't have a lot of hair in your arm. I promise you. Okay. So, we are all set. I'm just gonna grab a paper towel. A little more water. I try to be as thorough as possible. You're doing great. Even though, of course, we haven't gotten to the actual tattooing, but you're doing great. Okay, I'm gonna remove these and put on some new gloves. Now, this procedure is kind of similar. We removed some hair. Now we're just going to cleanse the skin a bit. So I have this. And this is tincture of green soap. It's a liquid detergent and cleaner for cleansing skin and scalp. So, what we're going to do here is take the remaining water from this bottle and add some it's all a process. Okay. So, mix this up. And I'm just going to cleanse this area. Excellent. Okay. Again, paper towels. Paper towels are a tattoo artist's best friend. Are you ready? And you're comfortable. Excellent. a little bit of prepping to do, but I have my inks here. So I have the red ink. Yes, I use mom's tattoo ink. Yeah, I'm a mom of two, so very fitting. And I have the blue. I have the black, and I have the white. Yeah, that one's for mixing. I also have my ink caps. Yeah, I have them various sizes depending on how much color I use. Those are the larger ones, these are like the medium ones. And yeah, that's how they look like when they're all filled up. This one has black ink. So I'm going to go ahead and peel off the stencil here. Hold still so we can get the proper placement. Now, the needle, of course. And everything is clean, sterilized, and has never been used. So everything is one use only. And then we throw it away. Okay, so here is the tattoo needle. Let me take it out. And place it into my tattoo gun. And we are ready to go. Okay. So, are you ready? Okay. So we're gonna start out with the outline, of course. Okay. So just stay still. If there is any discomfort, if you need any breaks, please let me know. Okay? Yes, do not feel afraid to let me know. Okay. Okay. How's that? So, is your sleeve going to have any theme? Yeah, just what you like. I agree. I feel like not every tattoo has to have a super, meaningful story behind it. Sometimes it's okay to just get a tattoo for the fun of it because you like the style. There really doesn't have to be a major reason. As long as you love it, of course, because it is permanent. Yeah, then again, nothing is permanent, right? You can get removed. Although I have done that, and it's not the best feeling. My first tattoo, I actually got my first tattoo with my mom. Yeah, when I turned 21. Yeah, and the tattoo artist was like, well, welcome to your new addiction. And he wasn't joking. Yeah. Here we are now. It was all part of the plan, more or less. Good. Give some say that the outline is the easy part. And some say the outline is the worst part. So, I don't know, I guess it's just personal preference. Or who does it, or maybe the tattoo itself. But, some people say getting the tattoo actually colored in is the worst part. I would say I'm definitely in that category. I feel like the outline is fine. Getting it colored in is the hard part. Yeah, I think it's the filling in and the rubbing of the needle back and forth when you're filling in the color and the shading and so the outline. Excellent. Okay. So let's get some paper towel once again. I will say that you're not much of a bleeder, so that's good. Not yet. Just kidding. I see your little, platelets. Yeah, that's what those are. And, we call those your little, it's like your army. It's basically going to heal you. It's already healing you. Let's just say that. So, that's excellent. Okay, so now moving on to color. So, go ahead and get some red. I love the blue. Yeah, it's really, really pretty. Okay, some light. Ready? This is where the magic happens. I personally love color tattoos. I mean, I love seeing someone just completely decked out in black tattoos. But, I don't know, there's just something about the vibrancy of a color tattoo. I'm kind of dipping the blue with the red, going back and forth, kind of mixing the colors. It creates this kind of watercolor effect. That's kind of what we're doing here. I personally love tattoos that kind of look watercolor. You're bleeding just a little bit. Do you find this part for people? Just the same. That's fair. Where's the worst place that I got a tattoo? I have to think about that. Probably the side of my hip. Any place where it's kind of bony, it's probably going to hurt. Finger tattoos. I love finger tattoos. But they are one of the more painful. We are done, my friend. Yes. Okay. So that is looking excellent. It looks really good, and I can already tell that healing time is going to be really quick with you. Just clean it off that. I'm gonna go ahead and apply some salve. This is our homemade salve. Yeah, smell it. It smells so good, right? So, you were gonna go home with some of this. This is what it looks like, okay? And it has zinc. very similar to Andy, but much more better in my opinion. I know I'm kind of biased, but trust me. Yes. When I was getting tattoos when I was younger, I would use Andy. And healing time wasn't very fast. And to be honest, I got sick of the smell of Andy. Yeah, hardcore. So, okay, now I'm gonna go ahead and take this Band-Aid. Okay, just to keep it away from the elements, the elements, the elements, the elements. Okay, so you're all set. Did you get the care sheet? Yeah, it tells you all about the aftercare. Okay, so you got that up in the front. Okay, excellent. So, I hope that you continue to enjoy your tattoo, and please, you know, definitely come back. I would definitely appreciate it. I would love to do a couple more things to your sleeve. Yeah, so, thank you so much for coming in today, and yeah, again, please feel free to come back. We would greatly appreciate it.